Welcome, students. In this lecture, we will discuss energy balances. But before I start with the energy balance of countries, I would like to familiarize you with the concept of energy balances on a simple level. So let's sketch an example. Mr. Messi lives in a nice house in Barcelona with his wife and son. Their house is connected to the electricity grid from where they get power every day. This results in a flow called purchased power. But Messi has quite a sustainable mindset and invested in solar panels on his roof. This leads to the flow own extraction. Because it is so sunny in Barcelona, Mr. Messi generates more solar power than he needs at certain moments. The power surplus is sold to the national grid. With these flows, we can determine the net energy available for the Messi family. This is purchased energy minus sold power plus own extraction. The luxurious life Mr. Messi and his family live is reflected in their energy use, which is quite high. Energy is used for cooking, entertainment, communication, heating, and hygiene, among others. For this energy use, various conversions take place in the house. Hence, the final energy can be defined as net energy available plus output from the in-house conversion processes minus the input to these conversions. The in-house conversions are generation of power and heat in combined heat and power plants. The conversion in the coffee machine, for example, is not included. Note that these flows will always have to be in balance, as energy can neither be destroyed nor created, but only converted into other energy carriers. The table you see here represents a simplified energy balance of the Messi household, without the actual values. The positive factors represent an energy output, while the negative factors indicate energy inputs. This concept of energy balances can also be applied on a larger aggregation level, such as countries or regions. On a country level, an energy balance is typically presented as a matrix. In this matrix, each row represents a sector, such as the industry and transport, while columns represent an energy carrier, such as coal or natural gas. These energy balances are compiled for all countries annually by the International Energy Agency in cooperation with the United Nations. Now, let's run you through the process of setting up an energy balance for the country to Delftsia. First of all, we start with the energy available for to Delftsia, or the upstream part of the energy system. Energy is made available through the winning of energy carriers, such as oil and natural gas, of which to Delftsia has a vast amount of reserves. To Delftsia is also investing in hydroelectric plants. This can be noticed by the positive value in the column concerning ocean and hydro energy. These facilities produce electricity without earth resource as input. Additionally, coal is imported from Australia, while oil and oil products are imported from various countries. On the other hand, energy carriers in the form of oil and oil products and natural gas are exported to several countries. As you can see, the exports have a negative sign, as the exports need to be subtracted from the energy available to Delftsia. When we sum up these energy flows, we get the total primary energy supply, or TPES. This is a common indicator for a country's total energy use. In an equation, we can define TPES as energy winning plus imports minus exports. The next step is the conversion sector. Here, refineries and power plants are the most important components. These refineries and power plants are utilized to convert the primary energy to secondary energy, which can be used by society and industry. And these secondary energy carriers are, for example, gasoline and electricity. The power plants have, on the one hand, energy input, which is primary energy, such as coal and natural gas in this case, with a negative sign. On the other hand, there is energy output, secondary energy in the form of electricity, which has a positive sign. The relationship between the energy output and input is called the conversion efficiency of the power plants. Note that the hydropower generated is also subtracted in the row of the power plants, but then added straight away in the general electricity production cell with 100% efficiency. The next summation row is called total final consumption, or TFC. The TFC equation can be expressed as the TFC is TPS minus the conversion energy input plus the conversion energy output. As this is an energy balance, taking into account the law of conservation of energy, the TFC is also the sum of the final energy use for the various sectors in Tudelsia. In this balance, you can see the industry, transport, services, and the residential sector. With transport, you should think about personal and private mobility, public transport, inland shipping and aviation. Industry, or making things, includes all industrial processes requiring energy and also the commercial activities related to the industry which require energy. Residential is a sector in which we include spatial heating for houses, illumination, etc. And the service sector is, for example, the energy use of banks and other offices. Now back to the energy balance. The last column provides the total energy flow per sector over the various energy carriers in the other columns. This total provides a good mean for energy statistics because, among others, you can say something about how much energy the country exports in total or how much energy is used in total by the industry in that country. In this lecture, you have been walked through the process of constructing an energy balance for a country. However, this balance is quite simplified. The actual energy balances of countries are far more detailed. Stay with us to also understand the real energy balances.